Hi viewers, this is me, Professor Mumtaz Ali, Department of English, Government Postgraduate College, Chakwal. Today in this lecture, I am going to talk about structuralism. Structuralism with reference to linguistics and also structuralism with reference to literary theory. It means that I am going to talk about this structuralism by keeping in mind that how it is studied with reference to linguistics and then how it is used in literary theory or how it is used to understand literature. So whereas this definition of this structuralism is concerned, that definition is that nothing can be understood in isolation. It means that each and everything that is existing in this world, each and every culture, each and every social system, each and every political, moral, ethical and religious system, there are so many systems, there are so many religions, there are so many communities, there are so many cultures, there are so many civilizations. It means that there is something that can be called that there is a thing which is structure. There is an underlying structure that becomes the basis of that system. So whereas this concept is concerned, it means that everything in this universe or every culture is a compact whole. Nothing can be understood in isolation. If we are to, for example, if we are to understand this structuralism, then we will have to move towards the understanding of structure. And for this, there is an example that suppose we are to understand this, the concept of this second, and second itself is a structure. This concept of second is a structure. So we cannot understand this concept until we are not in the position to understand the concept of a minute, that is of 60 seconds. And then there will be a difficulty that we will not be in the position to understand the concept of minute until we don't understand the hour. And the concept of hour can be best known when we are in the position to know that what is meant by 24 hours, because this and hour is a part of those 24 hours. Then when we study 24 hours, it means that there is a concept of a day, and when we move towards days, there are 7 days, and that's called a week. It means that in order to understand these days, we will have to understand the concept of weeks, and weeks, in order to understand, we will have to move still towards another structure, that is of month. And there are 12 months, and in order to understand those months, we will have to move still towards one thing, that is year. It means that all these second, minute, or 24 hour, 1 day, and then week, month, year, these are all structures. But one structure is above the other, and we will have to keep in mind the other structure that is above that so that we can understand. So the underlying system or underlying structure among all these is that is the concept of time. As here it is time, in the same manner there are structures which are running like a thread through the veins of cultures, through the veins of social, political, moral, ethical, economical and religious systems, and also passing through the civilization. It means that there are underlying structure. We cannot understand anything by keeping in mind until we don't keep in mind the underlying structure. So whereas now we are going to move towards structuralism with reference to linguistics. So the very important name with reference to structuralism, with reference to that linguistics, is of Ferdinand D. Saussure, and he is also called the founder of this structuralism or the founder of modern structuralism. So he was of the view that this language is a system of signs. Whereas the language is a system of signs, indeed, then he says that in order to understand meanings, this sign system, which is called language by Saussure, he says that it has different forms in order to draw meaning. For example, he says that the very first concept provided by him with regard to signs is that there's a concept of a signifier and there is the concept of a signified. Now what is a signifier? Means each and every word which is used to refer to something, that is called a signifier. It can be in written form, it can be in oral form, or it can be in the form of even in a picture. It means that we are going to refer to something, so that is a signifier. And the thing which is referred to, that real thing, that is called signified. For example, there is a word man. It is written, or I'm speaking. It means that that word is a signifier and the real man is signified. Similarly, the word dog, the word tree, the word room, the word blackboard, the word whiteboard, all these are signifiers and the real things are signified. So this is the first one. It means that he was of the view that we can understand meanings by keeping in mind this relationship of a signifier and a signified. Then the other method of understanding meaning with reference to linguistics is that is of arbitrariness. Arbitrariness means that there is no logical relationship between a signifier and a signified. It means that there can be use of a signifier or a signified according to the demand of the person, according to the demand of the situation, and according to the place and time. It means that for one signifier there can be so many signifieds. In the same manner, for one signified there can be so many signifiers, and this relation is not a logical relation, or this is not one-to-one relation. It can vary, it can change with the passage of time and demand of the time. Then language is a system of difference. Now, whereas this language is a system of differences, it means that one thing is understood by keeping in mind the opposite of that, and this is also called binary opposition. It means that we can understand the meanings of different concepts by keeping in mind, by understanding the opposites of those. For example, morning, evening, then day, night, in, out, up, down, good, bad. So all these are examples of binary position. And one thing is, the language is a system of difference. Means that, for example, there is a man, so he is a man because there is no woman. So absence of one thing is responsible for the existence of the other thing, and in this way, through binary position, we can also understand meanings. Then there are these two concepts are very much important in order to understand such structuralism as a literary theory. Lang means that total system of any language is called lang. Total system means words, vocabulary, and then grammatical rules, different types of whatever is there, they are called lang. It means total system of any language is called lang. And parallel means that how much language a person is capable of using. For example, if we think that English language is lang of English language, it means the total system of English language is called lang. And if a person, how much English language a person is capable of using, that's called parallel. Now we are going to move towards structuralism as a literary theory, or structuralism in literature. So in linguistics, these are the things through which we can understand meaning through signifier and signified, their relationship. And then it is told that there is that relation is arbitrary, and then through binary position, and then we are going towards lang and parallel. Now, whereas this lang is concerned with reference to literature and reference to literary theory. In linguistic, lang means total system of any language. But in literary theory, if we are moving towards the understanding of the literature, here it is said that lang means total system of any society. Total system of any society means the total political system, total ethical system, total moral system, total economic system, total religious system, and each and every system that is existing in any society from A to Z, that is a part of lang. Whenever there is a society existing, there is language also existing. It means that there are so many ideas existing there, and those ideas are called ideology. Now, when a person is born, ideology is already existing in his or her society. Then we move towards parallel. Now, what is parallel? Parallel means that how much a language a person is capable of using. But in this system, or with reference to literature or literary theory, it means that how much a person is capable of adopting the ideology of that system from that society. This is called the parallel of society. Now, the most important question is that how it is dealt as a literary theory in literary theory and with reference to understanding of literature. It means that whenever a person is born, before his birth, total language, a total system of a language or lang is always existing. For example, if there is language is existing in any society, when language is existing, it means that ideologies are also existing. When ideology is existing, so when a person is born, whether he is a writer or any other person, when he starts learning that language of that society in which he is born, it means that he is also learning the ideology of that. He learns the political ideology, he learns the social ideology, he learns the philosophical ideology, he learns the cultural ideology, he learns the economic ideology, he learns the religious ideology. It means that he learns because society is always having for that man. So when he has learned that, no, society wants the people or wants the writers that they must learn my ideology. So this is the demand of the society. When society is demanding this, so through language it is conveyed in the mind of that writer. And then that writer tries to write something in the form of a drama, novel, short story or poetry. When he writes that, no, we can say that when a writer is writing something, he can never say, the writer can never say that, no, I am the only person who can give meaning to it, or I am the person who is free to write something. So structuralism is of the view that no person is, or no writer is free to write something. He is bound in the society, he is bound in the ideology of that society, he is bound to write about the political systems, he is bound to write about social, moral, ethical and religious systems. It means that he has learned the language of that society. When he has learned the language of that society, now he is not a person who can give, we can say that he is the only source of meaning. No. According to structuralism, to understand the meanings of a piece of literature, we can say that any individual is not the source of meaning. It means that writer is not the source of meaning. So what are the sources of meanings? Sources of meanings are lying there in the structure which he has observed and he is trying to convey. So in order to understand a piece of work through structuralism, we must keep in mind the peril of that person and also the lang of that person. Peril of that person means that how much ideology he has adopted, how much ideology he has conveyed to the society. So so if we apply this structuralism to a piece of literature, so we will have to keep in mind the social, political, moral, ethical, religious and all those types of values, because these values are having structures, there are underlying structures. So a writer is a part of society. Writer takes everything from society. He takes the material for his drama, novel, short story or poetry from society. He uses the language of the society and then he tries to express the ideology of the society. So he apparently thinks that I am a user of language, but actually language uses him. And he thinks that I have made this language to be my slave, but actually he is slave of that language. So structuralism as a literary theory means that a writer cannot be the source of meaning. The source of meaning will be the structure which is providing each and everything to the person. So nothing can be understood. It means that a piece of literature only can be understood by if we understand the real structure of that society. Without structure, nothing exists.